Dear all, welcome to Civil Services Mississippi at IAS Academy. Today we are going to launch a new video series, and as you know, this video series is related to environmental topics. So basically, these are new emerging environmental topics which are related to exams regarding the UPSC and other competitive exams, whether it is BPSC, UPPCSC, or all other competitive exams. It's also both beneficially in prelims and mains. So today we will discuss these questions regarding the main purpose, but it is also very significant for the prelims review. So start with today's topic. Today's topic is, what are the climatopias? And as you know, it is a new emerging topic, and these topics are basically related to how to fight climate change and global warming, biodiversity loss, and so on. So let's start with introduction. So see the introduction. So basically, the term climatopias is emerged from the climate change, urban planning, and sustainable development. Basically, if you see climatopia, climatopias is basically intersection between the climate change. So basically these three things, climate change, urban planning, and sustainable development. So sustainable development. So basically three things is basically main component of these urban planning climatopia. So basically it is that why this type of planning needed, because the climate change and extreme weather event, such type of the rising sea levels, extreme weather event, biodiversity loss. So climatopias are explored the potential solution. So it is the potential solutions for the global warming, climate change, and the biodiversity loss. So see, if we see the climatopia, so basically here we see climatopias are the term combined with the climate plus utopia. Climate means how to fight the climate. Utopia means imagines society. So such type of society in which all the people are basically binding with the law and imagine society. So ideal situation. So basically it is typical ideal situation, but we must need to adopt this situation. So it is a visionary, see this type of the like the floating city, like this type of the green spaces in urban areas and all that. So basically if you see, it is a visionary urban environment design. So basically you design your urban areas such that so you can stay with the climate change and adopt all things. So see here, climatopias can define as, if you see here, visionary urban and regional environment design. So basically people thrive under the changing climate, sustainability, and resilience. So basically these area integrate advanced technology, ecological principles, and community engagement. So three things. First, advanced technology, such type of the satellite imaging, satellite detection of the greenhouse gases and track is all there. So cutting edge technology, and also use such type of the biological and genetic engineering for fight this type of the ecology. And another is ecological principle. So another is ecology. So we also regarding this advancement. And another thing is engagement of the community. So engagement of the community is also very significant. Because if you see the such type of the tribal community, no better than the scientists for the fighting the environment and climate change and extreme weather. So it's also very, very significant to fill the gap of the inequality between the community, imagine society community like the climatopia. So that's why it is very significant term. So let's we move forward and see what are the key features of the climatopia. So see what are the key features of the climatopia. So as see here, it is the engagement of the community, such type of the engagement of the community. Such type of the space technology, we can use genetic technology, we can use modeling of the climate. So all these such type of the environmental filtering and all that, so we can fight easily with the urban planning for the forest fire, such type of the pollution and etc. So that's why we need such type of the visionary urban planning or such type of the regional planning. So let's see what are the key features of the climatopias. So key features of the climatopia. So first is the innovative design. So we must design innovative way. So that's why so city thrives in the changing climate. So see here, like the floating city for the sea level rising. Such type of the example is the lily pad city, a concept, amphibious house, means house sustaining both water and land, amphibious, and also neighborhood built on water. So these designs are intended to adapt rising sea levels, increased flood risk. So these type of the house are basically flood resistant, some type of the floating residence, so you see. So these are the basically adaptation towards the climate change. So see such type of the lily pad city. See here. It is lily pad city. So see one such type of the lily pad city. So see. Basically this city, floating city concept, if you see lily pad city. Lily pad city basically a concept by the resident Colbert. So Wesley Colbert designed this type of the city, so people can thrive regarding the this type of the climate change and sea level rising across the globe. So this type of the city use 100% sustainability and ecological principle, and also zero carbon emission. So it is also very significant for the zero carbon emission. So basically these city are in future, will be in the future for the climate. As you know, the certain reports and various reports regarding the sea level rising across the globe. So that's why these cities are very, very significant, and also use such type of the ecological principles, space, green space and greenery and all that. So let's see another thing, another key feature. So if you see another key feature is sustainable infrastructure. So you build such type of the infrastructure, so use only solar, wind and geothermal energy. For instance, city like the Mersan in Abu Dhabi, so see here such type of the sustainable infrastructure, use no fossil fuel, only green fuels or such type of the solar, geothermal. One example is Abu Dhabi city in zero carbon environment. So it is zero emission. So what is difference between zero emission and net zero? If you want to know more about this topic, you can watch this video. This video is very significant to clear your confusion regarding the certain environmental concept, like what is zero emission, what is net zero and all that. So you can watch this video in our channel. So basically it is zero carbon environment. See such type of the sub city in Abu Dhabi, UAE. Another key feature is, if you see here, another key feature is green spaces. So basically green spaces is very significant in urban planning. So if you plan urban areas, residents, so you need such type of the green space. So incorporating park, green roof and urban forest. So you need to green your roof with certain plants and also certain parks and urban forest. So it's help to manage storm water, reduce heat island, so all that, so and improve air quality. So if you see the recent research, so a recent research basically find that urban greenery can lower temperature by 1 to 5 degrees Celsius. So if your urban areas is more green, then it reduces temperature 1 to 5 degrees Celsius. That is very, very significant research. So regarding the research and all that, you can join our current affairs class. Okay, so see here, such type of the green space. See, such type of the green space. So green space means such type of the park, green park, such type of the green roof, such type of the green roof. That is called green roof. So it is green roofs. So green roofs, green park, and also you can see urban forest like this. This is called urban forest. So that's why this is very, very significant. Climatopia is very, very significant. Fight the climate change and global warming. The another key point is resilience planning. So basically these type of the planning community are designed to withstand with extreme weather, such type of the flood resistance building or such type of the flood resistance infrastructure. So see how. So basically one of the example for this is Rotterdam has implemented flood resistance infrastructure. So what is flood resistance infrastructure? We also know about. So basically it is very, very significant. See here, it is called Water Plaza Bentiplane Rotterdam. So it is very, very significant and it is using flood resistance. So basically these type of the basketball ground and all these area filled with water and store water, and then in the coming dry days these water used for the residents. So we can see in this animation here. So see here, see this type of the. So basically this type of the basketball field and all collect rainwater and the flood water, and after collecting these water they use in the dry season or dry days. So that's why it is very, very significant type of the resilient planning. So you can plan basically to resist the such type of the flood areas, and basically as you know in our cities like Delhi and Mumbai, such type of social. So basically these type of the basketball ground have about 200 liters one water, and it is 8,500 this type of the water, and it basically it's collect about 1.7 million liters water in every such type of the rainy season or the flood situation. And when the seasons dry, the community of these areas, such type of the area in Rotterdam, use this water. So that's why we need such type of the resilient planning in India, because as you know, in rainy seasons or the flood season, flood situations is basically recently in Delhi, in Mumbai, such type of the rainy season. So see, such type of the flood, and so we can use this type of the planning in our India also. So see, next key feature of the Climatopia. So next key feature is community engagement. So community engagement is also very significant for fight the climate change. So it's emphasized the participatory governance, where residents involved in decision making, not one person, and because all persons are similar, so process regarding their environment to social inequality. So basically, one thing is to eradicate social inequality. Every residents have the equal right for the planning. So ensuring that all community members have access to resources and opportunity within a new environment and new this type of the climate. So this approach not only fosters the community spirit but also leads more tailored solutions that reflected. As you know, such type of the participatory planning is very, very significant, because some of the recent ecological type of the solution emerged from the tribal community. So basically, if you see such type of the tribal area and tribals also use such type of the climate resistance habitat in the millions of years ago and all that. So we can also engage the community for the planning. So Climatopias, as you know, the innocence community. So in that, basically it is very futuristic, but it's also used to engage the community for the planning, for the whether it is renewable and all that. So that's why one is this component is also very significant. Another component is mobility solutions. So as you know, the transport is one of the most basically contributing the global warming across the globe, whether it is city transports and all that. So we need such type of the mobilities like the electric public transit system, electric public transit system, extensive cycling network. So we can use extensive cycling or walking in the cities. So basically essential feature of the Climatopia. So the city of Copenhagen is one of the example of this type of the initiation, where 60% of people use bike daily. So use cycle daily. So that's why it is mobility solution. So we need such type of the green solution, green mobility. So such type of the e-rickshaw and electric bus, electric car, and extensive use of cycling. That is very, very significant for the fighting for the climate change or such type of the amazing community or Climatopia. So next is sustainability goal. Basically, as you know, one thing is basically Climatopia represent a proactive approach to the climate adaptations and mitigations. So it is adaptation. It means you can adapt regarding the climate change, sea level rising and flooding, and also mitigate. So also mitigate the such type of the climate, like you plant such type of the tree and your temperature is lower than 1 to 5 degrees C, such type of the green space. So that's why this type of the adaptation and mitigation is very significant for the basically outlining a framework like the Paris Agreement, and also promoting sustainable development. So the concept encourages interdisciplinary collaboration among the architect, urban planners, environmental scientists, and policy makers. So policy maker also need to know such type of that ecological things and all that scientific thing. So basically it is very significant because these are the significant for the fighting for the climate change. So that's why it is the concept encourage interdisciplinary collaboration among the architect, environmental scientist, urban planners and policy maker. So policy maker must need to solve this type of the problem. So see here, such type of the sustainable goal. So as you know, this is basically this is climatopias. So climatopias is a futuristic design, futuristic society, imagined society, but no in taking to the it's taking to the same and emerging the across the globe various places. So some of the examples of the climatopias. So notable examples of the climatopias are, number one, if you see here, Songdo International Business District, South Korea. So this smart city incorporate advanced technology for waste management and energy efficiency. That's why this is very significant. Waste management and energy efficiency. So this city basically recycled such type of the waste water and also reclaimed the land from the Yellow Sea. So it's also reclaimed the land from Yellow Sea, South Korea. So that's why it is very, very significant example. Another, so see here, this is land reclaimed by the Songdo International Business District, South Korea. Another example is the Great Green Wall in Africa. Basically, the Great Green Wall is also one of the significant example of the climatopia, and you see it is basically comeback for the desertification across the Sahel region. So as you know, what is the Sahel region and all that. So if you want to know more about the what is the Great Green Wall, so you must watch our this video, separate video on this type of the Great Green Wall. So you can find this type of the video. So you can find several video in our channel, and as you know, regarding past 3 years, about 21 plus question directly from our civil services with Zaki PT, and also some of the significant questions like the James Webb Telescope from Maine. So that's why this channel is very significant for you and your colleagues who are preparing for the civil services examination, whether it is a state PCS or other competitive examination. So another example is Maldives Floating City. So Maldives Floating City, see here, floating city. So see here, these cities are made in the such type of the level. So basically these are the some of the new design basically happening across the globe. So basically climatopia is a futuristic view or futuristic planning for the urban development and all that. So it is very significant for the your main exam. So finally concluding, in conclusion, basically if you see here, climatopias embody an optimistic vision for the future. So basically it is optimistic vision for the future. So such type of the forest fire, global warming, eco diversity loss, and such type of the biodiversity loss, and various type of the climate catastrophe. So we can fight these in future for this type of the solution, climatopias. So basically it is the foresight and responsibility towards the people and the planet. So we also are responsible people and also responsibility towards the planet. So planet is also healthy and our people, not they eradicate the inequality and all that. So people and planets both both are benefited with this climatopias or futuristic society. So basically, it is enhancing the resilience, innovative environment can serve as model for the addressing global climate challenges effectively. Such type of the design, like the green space, like the green roof. Another is such type of the sustainable waste management, treating the waste water and all that, and reclaiming the basically sea land, like this Songdo city in South Korea. And another is such type of the, and also we can use ecological principle. Ecological principle, like this type of the. So now we conclude it, and finally this is the climatopia. I hope you can easily understand what is the climatopia, what is the features of the climatopia, and what are the examples of the climatopia. So before we going, we very thankful to IAS Academy. I am very thankful to you and all our viewers for watching this video, because this is basically the collaboration with the our IAS Academy and Civil Services with Zaki. So thanks for watching this video. Before going, IAS Academy recently launched a new BPSC, especially for the BPSC. As you know, BPSC is one of the most significant civil services examination in the Bihar. So IAS Academy and Civil Services with Zaki provide you such type of the new latest video in current affairs, and also launch a course on BPSC. So you, if you are BPSC aspirant, you must join IAS Academy. Thanks for watching this video. Thanks a lot. We will meet next video with next new environment.